In this video, we'll go over how to run the PipFill hole punch tool. As mentioned in an earlier video, you will need to provide your own DEM, which should extend to the buffered watershed boundary, which is 1,000 meters beyond the actual watershed boundary. However, many times the LiDAR-derived DEMs have noise, meaning that artifacts exist which show up as small, false depressions shown in this image on the right. These depressions, or pits, need to be filled. This is where the pit fill hole punch tool smooths the DEM using a two-step process. The inputs are relatively simple. We need our DEM, and then we need to specify our maximum fill depth, and this will be measured with the same vertical units as your DEM. Your output will be your pit fill DEM, which is why an underscore P will be placed after the DEM name. First off, pits are going to be filled by identifying one cell sinks, and those are cells that are deeper than all other surrounding cells but have no flow into them. The sink tool is ran to find those one cell sinks and null them. Fill is then ran, and the original DEM is subtracted from the filled. Any positive values represent the sinks, and then those cells are assigned the corresponding filled DEM values. Second, tool depressions are then hole punched. The first step is to subtract the unfilled DEM from the filled to return sink areas. These areas are identified as individual regions. If the sink is deeper than our maximum filled depth, that is considered a true depression. And for those regions, the deepest cell is nulled, which allows the water to flow out of it, and hence, it has been hole punched. This tool goes through multiple iterations to catch sinks within the depressions. It'll go through as many iterations it needs until only true depressions remain. Okay, so let's go ahead and run the tool. We'll navigate over to our most recent version of our ACPF toolbox, and we'll go into the first tool set, that's DEM preparation, and then open the first tool, DEM, pit fill, and hole punch. I want to take a moment to point out that each of these tools have a tool help with them. If you hit this show help, each ACPF tool will have a broad overview on how it works and what its purpose is. And then as you click on the individual inputs or outputs, there is a brief description going over them. And also, if they can have variable inputs, it'll explain why that matters. All right. So as we can see in the background here, we have our watershed boundary in yellow. We have the buffered boundary that's extending 1,000 meters beyond this boundary, shown in red, and then our DEM that has not been pit filled or hole punched is sitting there behind it. So we'll go and get our tool, and the only input is our DEM. So we'll come and drag this in there, and we can see the output's been automatically populated, and it is naming it with this underscore P after the base name. This underscore P stands for pit filled. And then our second required input is the maximum fill depth, which will be in the same Z units as your DEM. We suggest choosing a maximum fill depth that is comparable to the vertical accuracy of your DEM. This often ranges from 0.1 to 0.3 meters. The metadata associated with your DEM should have information about the vertical accuracy of the data. My DEM is in centimeters, and so my max fill depth is going to be 30 centimeters. Our output will be this pit filled hole punch DEM, and it is going to iterate through that pit fill hole punch process until any depressions that are less than this 30 centimeters depth have been filled. So okay, let's hit okay. I just want to point out that this tool is going to take quite a while to run. So don't worry if it is taking a while, but because of that, When it finishes, you're just going to have your pit fill and hole punch DEM. You may not see many differences, but I'm going to show you an example next up that shows you how much difference this process can actually make. So once the tool is finished, you will have a newly pit filled and hole punched DEM. Now we have a much smoother DEM. Shown in the images below, you can see that many artifacts have been removed in this process. This new DEM now better represents the actual surface and allows our surface to flow more correctly downstream while maintaining true depressions that are in the landscape. Here's a brief recap on how to run the pit fill hole punch tool.